Senator Laila De Lima is convinced that FB Jamber 1 Captain Junel Insigne was coerced to suddenly change his tune on the ramming incident at Recto Bank following their meeting with Agriculture Secretary Manny Piñol. In a letter she had written at Camp Crame, De Lima said it was obvious that the Filipino fishermen were forced to concur with the government's narrative. She said the fishermen were left drowning again, with the government supposedly betraying them for siding with China. Likewise, the Makabayan Bloc in Congress believes that the Duterte administration is covering up for the Chinese embassy.
Kasinungalingan ang nilabas ng Chinese embassy. So, sunod na punto ay malinaw na pinagtatakpan ng Duterte administration mula kay Pangulong Duterte mismo, kay Panelo at sa iba pang mga opisyal niya. Gustong patahimikin talaga ng administrasyong ito ang mga mangingisda mismo at ang galit ng mamamayan. At malinaw naman ang mas malaking interest na inahabol ni Pangulong Duterte dito, ang pagpapatuloy ng mga pautang na napakalaking interes, mga proyekto na maaring magbaon sa atin sa Pilipinas sa mas malalim na utang sa China at ginagamit na collateral, including ang Recto Bank.
But Piñol defended himself, saying the seafarers had not been intimidated to revise their accounts. As a matter of fact, he said there are still some who think that the elision was intentional. Others said it was just an accident. Mixed accounts require an investigation, he said. The only thing that has changed, according to Piñol, was Insigne getting clear about the truth, that he was not really summoned by the president to Malacanang, in contrast with his earlier claim. Piñol also clarified that the items and the loans they issued were not bribes and were actually one of existing government assistance programs. Piñol assured his critics that he had nothing to do with the deployment of cops in full battle gear during their closed-door meeting. The official challenged his critics to simply ask the fishermen and find out the truth themselves. For News 5, Ria Fernandez, We Are One News.
JP Garjones has always dreamed of having his own bangka. Now his dream has come true. Though he's sharing the boat with another crew member of FB Jember, he said it is enough. But when asked about the crew's turnaround in their account of the Reed Bank incident, JP seems lost for words.
Ano ba yung parang nagbutuhan kayo? Tinanong kayo na
nilapot. JP would rather talk about the Vietnamese who rescued them from the cold waters.
Papasalamat din ako sa mga Vietnam na tumulong sa amin. Na sana hindi po sila manawa sa aming tumulong, hindi sila magbago. Sa ilang pasalamatan po, dahil sila ang sumagip sa amin.
Even Antonio Torres, one of the outspoken member of the Recto Bank 22, couldn't explain why the sudden retraction, that they are now uncertain whether they were intentionally rammed.
Sa paulit-ulit siguro na tanong, kaya ano, parang yung gano'n na, minsan nalilito na yung iba.
Pero hindi naman kayo tinakot ka mo na ito ang sabihin, gano'n.
Hindi.
But now, Torres says he's just happy for all the assistance that they have received, saying it is all that they could ask for.
Na ano na, nagahilom na.
Nagahilom na? Bakit?
Kasi nung una, iniisip namin parang kung ano, walang may nakakonsamin, baka kaming lahat wala dito, hindi kami nakabalik.
Pero nung nagdinig yung gobyerno, medyo
parang ano, talagang hindi rin talaga pabaya yung gobyerno sa mga kababayan ng mga Pilipino. Talagang may action pa rin talaga.
Even Lani Insigne, the captain's wife who aired his frustration to the president a couple of days ago, is singing a different tune.
Wala naman ako nanakit kay Duterte. At Duterte kami.
Love mo, love.
Oo naman. Yun ang binoto namin eh. Kaya na, wala naman akong galit. Hindi naman ako galit. Doon lang talaga sa ano. Yung China.
All that they want now is to hold the captain of the Chinese vessel accountable and to go back to Recto Bank to continue fishing in peace. For News 5, Romel Lopez. We Are One News.